Ever since the United States added Huawei to its entity list in 2019, its chip designing subsidiary, HiSilicon, became Huawei's main source of chips. Back then, HiSilicon was the second largest customer of TSMC. When more sanctions followed, not only was HiSilicon deprived of TSMC's advanced manufacturing processes, its alternative supplier, Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation, or SMIC, was also barred from obtaining ASML's EUV or extreme ultraviolet lithography equipment. SMIC is China's homegrown champion to rival TSMC, but has been facing difficulties with progressing to 7 nanometer and beyond without the EUV machines. According to SMIC, it can only manufacture a 40 nanometer node without US suppliers. According to the US media, the Wall Street Journal on July 17th, an American official revealed that the Biden administration chose to continue the Trump-era policy after confirming the strategic value of EUV lithography machines in the technology industry. White House officials have contacted the Dutch government and asked the Netherlands to restrict the sale of EUV to mainland China on national security grounds. The report revealed that less than a month after Biden officially took office, his national security advisor, Jack Sullivan, has spoken to the Dutch side about close cooperation on advanced technology. U.S. officials revealed that it's Sullivan's top priority to continue to restrict ASML's cooperation with mainland China. At present, only one ASML company in the world can produce EUV photolithography machines. Globally, whether it's Intel in the United States, Samsung in South Korea, or TSMC in Taiwan, China, they're free to buy 180 tons of EUV to make chips for high-end electronic equipment. However, under pressure from the United States, the Dutch government has not approved the export of EUV to mainland China. U.S. pressure on the Dutch government began as early as Trump's term. Charles Kupperman, then the Deputy National Security Advisor to the United States, recalled that he invited Dutch diplomats to the White House in 2019 and pressured the latter that the faithful allies would not sell equipment such as EUV to mainland China. Kupperman also warned the Netherlands that as much as equipment would not work without American parts, and the White House had the right to restrict the export of these parts to the Netherlands. Recognizing the strategic importance of EUV machines and under pressure from the United States, in November 2019, the Dutch government prevented ASML from shipping an EUV machine to China. Related news coverage painted ASML as a pawn in the US-China trade war. Ever since, Huawei and the Chinese semiconductor industry have been striving to expand upstream, realizing that the IC manufacturing equipment is the choke point of the industry. Recently, industry watchers believe that Huawei has taken the first move to develop its photolithography equipment. Did China make its first domestic DUV lithography machine? On July 14th, the Shanghai Municipal Government issued the 14th five-year plan for the development of Shanghai advanced manufacturing industry. It's mentioned that during the 14th five-year plan period, the innovation and development of equipment materials will be strengthened, and the core process equipment of integrated circuit front channels such as photolithography machine, etching equipment, thin film equipment, ion injection equipment, wet equipment, detection equipment, etc. On November 29th, Beijing time, the Institute of Optoelectronic Technology of the Chinese Academy of Sciences announced that the National Research and Development Equipment Development Project, Super Resolution Lithography Equipment Development, passed the acceptance test and became the world's first 22-nanometer resolution lithography machine realized by the ultraviolet light source. Hussong said that the lithography machine has a maximum line width resolution of 22 nanometers in a single exposure at a wavelength of 365 nanometer, which is equivalent to 1 over 17 wavelength. In principle, the project breaks through the resolution diffraction limit and establishes a new high-resolution, large-area nanolithography equipment research and development route. It has completely independent intellectual property rights and is a revolution in metamaterials or supersurfaces, third-generation optical devices, and generalized chips. According to China Science and Technology Daily, Hussong, deputy director of the Institute of Optoelectronic Technology of the Chinese Academy of Sciences, revealed that the newly accepted lithography machine uses a 365-nanometer UV mercury lamp, a cost of only tens of thousands of dollars, while lithography, the price of the whole machine, is in the range of 1 million yuan to 10 million yuan. Hussong also said that the processing capability of the lithography machine, developed by the Institute of Optoelectronic Technology of the Chinese Academy of Sciences, is between the deep ultraviolet and extreme ultraviolet levels. What is EUV? An extreme ultraviolet lithography machine is a technological marvel. A generator ejects 50,000 tiny droplets of molten tin per second. A high-powered laser blasts each droplet twice. The first shape, the tiny tin, so the second can vaporize it into plasma. A EUV machine is made of more than 100,000 parts, costs approximately $120 million, and is shipped in 40 freight containers. There are only several dozen of them on Earth and approximately 2 years' worth of back orders for more. It might seem unintuitive that the demand for a $120 million tool far outstrips supply, but only one company can make them. It's a Dutch company called ASML, which nearly exclusively makes lithography machines for chip manufacturing. Despite this hyper-specialization, it has a market capitalization of more than $150 billion, much higher than IBM's and only slightly lower than Tesla's. Too, China has a long road to catch up with ASML. It remains to be seen what role Huawei will play in the development of China's first homegrown DUV machines. Ren Zhengfei, Huawei's founder and CEO, believes that China's semiconductor industry is mainly constrained by manufacturing equipment rather than chip design capabilities. But at the same time, Ren recognizes the high entry level to develop domestic chip manufacturing equipment given its complexity. According to SMEE, for example, despite its 20 years of lithography machine development, its current 90 nanometer equipment is still 10 years behind ASML's products. Is ASML reportedly worried about China's EUV progress? Despite the technology gap, ASML is said to be worried about China's catching up process. Justin Yifu Lin, a renowned Chinese economist and former vice president of the World Bank, has claimed that ASML CEO Peter Wennink is concerned about the U.S.'s ban on EUV equipment sales to China. The CEO reportedly believes that it'll take only 3 years for China to master advanced lithography machines, and by then it can produce them at lower, more competitive prices, ousting ASML from the global market in the process. Wennink has indeed been critical of the current U.S. sanctions on China, thinking that it'll only hasten the country's technology autonomy and eventually damage European industry in return. Seeing China's determination to break through semiconductor equipment, ASML CEO Wen Peter blurted to the United States in April this year, "If you take export control measures to exclude the Chinese market, it'll force them to fight for technological sovereignty on their real skills. In terms of sovereignty, in 15 years they'll be able to make all these things themselves, and the market for European suppliers will disappear completely." Despite ASML CEO Wen Peter's consecutive expressions of anxiety, the United States still chooses to turn a blind eye. According to Wen, if you want to stay ahead of China, you have to lead in innovations. The Wall Street Journal believes that it'll take at least 10 years for China to catch up with ASML's photolithography machines technology. Although Chinese research institutes have developed new lithography machines developed by ASML in the Netherlands are still the first choice for Chinese customers. At the end of May this year, according to Dutch media reports, the Chinese chip giant Yangtze Storage shipped a $72 million lithography machine ordered from ASML to Wuhan, Hubei. Another Japanese media reported that China's other chip maker, SMIC, also ordered a $120 million lithography machine from ASML, which is expected to be delivered in 2019.